Back with you for our feature match here on WCW Saturday Night. And I tell you, Brain, as we head to Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach, and fans, don't forget, is now only 1 week from this coming Sunday, a week away, you are taking a look at the big boys of World Championship Wrestling. And we got quite a main event for you, because Buckhouse Buck is one of the toughest men ever to step in the ring.
You know, and I think Savage is making a big mistake, because with this match with Flair, this isn't just a match. This is a vendetta. He's getting even for what Ric Flair did to his father, and when Ric Flair took the cane away from his father and used it to knock out Savage. And now he's going to be looking right through Bunkhouse Buck, and all he's going to be thinking about is a Slim Jim Bash at the Beach and getting his hands on Flair. But he's going to make a mistake. This Bunkhouse Buck with the Colonel in the corner could upset this man.
Here he is. And what an ovation. The Macho Man.
Watch the intensity in this man's eyes. I mean, this is for his father. He's reaching down now. This is emotion. This is... his heart is torn apart. But, you know, Vito left his dad on the porch. I looked him down a box of prunes. He'd be in a lot better shape than those Shady Acres.
All right. The Macho Man has cleared the ring. Buckhouse Buck and Colonel Rob Parker. And let me say, fans, as you know, Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach, it's going to be a lifeguard match. Now, for you fans who've been following the sport for many years, that is the same thing as a lumberjack match, which means people will be surrounding the ring, and the men surrounding the ring will be throwing either Flair or Savage back in should someone try to take the low road. And we all know at the Great American Bash recently, Flair stayed on the outside a great deal.
Well, Savage likes to go on the outside, too. Now, can you imagine this for a pay-per-view, Shivani? Something like I've never seen before. The wrestlers walking to the ring won't actually get sand on their boots. There will be sand probably in the ring from just the area, right? It's on the beach.
Yeah.
Can you imagine that rubbing in your elbow, in your chin, in your face? I mean, the body, the damage that beach match is going to do, I wouldn't want to be in anything like that. You know they're going to go out of the ring. You know they're going to go into the ocean. You know they're going to go all the way to Catalina. Maybe all the way to Australia. Who knows?
An elbow. Savage, like you said, he is like a man possessed. I mean, an elbow, and now just gouging at Buckhouse Buck and pulling at the beard of Buck. The Macho Man Randy Savage has become a fighter.
Well, he always was a fighter. He was trying to abide by the rules a little bit just so to keep from being fined. But I'll tell you something. He didn't know this was Buckhouse Buck he's in there with. Just as somebody he's beating on till he can get the flare. And it could backfire.
Yeah, the fact of the matter is he better focus on Buckhouse Buck and not take him lightly.
But understand this, Savage, and I hope you're listening, or one of your members of your family are, so they can relate this to you. Had your dad not been at ringside with a cane in his hand and used it first, Flair would have never taken it away from him and used it on you. Flair did what he had to do. When you say he's the dirtiest man in the sport, he may be. And you know, all those lifeguards around the ring, you know, Flair traveled in some pretty fast circles. Some of those lifeguards could be friends of his.
Forearm shot that time by Savage and back to a chokehold. And this is a Macho Man Randy Savage that we have not seen quite a while here on Saturday Night.
See, now if Savage goes out of the ring like that to get a hold of Flair, they're going to throw him back in the ring. Oh, look at this.
Savage.
Oh, he's on fire. He is burning. I know this man. I've been around him a lot of years. I've called his matches.
And made a big mistake here, Brain, because he ducked his head, enabling Buckhouse Buck while he was on the outside to regain his composure. And now the big guy from Tennessee is taking the measure of the Macho Man.
Oh,
oh, he did for a moment. The Macho Man with a foot and a big clothesline.
That's a disqualification as far as I'm concerned. He knew he was going to knock him over.
Well, you're not the referee. And now an irate Colonel Rob Parker echoing those sentiments, Brain. He feels the match should be over right now.
Well, I can't be wrong then. I'm agreeing with him.
Now, you both may be wrong.
Can you imagine that? 100,000 or so people screaming Macho. You'll be able to hear him all the way to Tijuana.
It is all going to be at Huntington Beach, California, on the beach with lifeguards around the ring. The lifeguard match.
What are you going to wear?
Wear to the Bash of the Beach?
Yeah. I'm not wearing a tuxedo out there in that
well,
heat.
Neither am I. We're going to wear our...
Don't wear that tea bag.
You're thinking the wrong person. I hope. The Macho Man now wanting Buck to get back in the ring. And Buck is in, and Savage, you talking about intensity. The Macho Man is hitting with everything. Buck still on his feet. And now Savage up top, looking Colonel Parker. Oh, he got the attention of the Macho Man, enabling Buckhouse Buck to get a key blow in that time.
Well, that's good, because Savage went after the Colonel, who did nothing to him, threatened the man with a chair, verbally assaulted him, so the Colonel yelled at him. Big deal. I was the Colonel here, knowing how the Colonel thinks, he should put, yes.
And that's exactly what he's doing. If Savage is not careful, when he gets to Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach, he will not be 100% for Ric Flair. And he doesn't want that to happen. He's got some payback. He remembers the cane. If you join us in the Great American Bash, up against his head, what Ric Flair did to him. And now Savage has to be concerned with Buckhouse Buck, who puts him on this floor. Not on the mat, but on the floor.
You know, Flair swung that cane so good when he hit Savage. George Steinbrenner told me he was willing to trade Strawberry for Flair.
Oh, think of another one now, would you?
What, you don't believe me?
No, I don't. Buck now trying to get a lateral press here on the Macho Man. And Nick Patrick doing his job checking. The Macho Man comes up swinging. Look at this.
You can't keep him down. Bunkhouse isn't going to stop him. Bunkhouse's best bet is to just get out of the ring, get counted out, and get out of there. Because this man is obsessed. This man's mind is on Ric Flair, the Nature Boy. And if you bring your dad to ringside in one of those old 1920 striped bathing suits with the leggings in it, you're going to be laughed right out of the city.
Oh, Buck with a big kick, and he put the Macho Man down. And now Buckhouse Buck is going up top. He may, no, sir, I thought Mayo that he would be moments from victory, but the Macho Man absorbed those blows. The Macho Man helps him down. He hit hard that time. Buck is still down.
Savage is going up.
Randy Savage up top with the big elbow.
It don't look good.
One, two, three. He wins again.
Look at his eyes. Look at his face. You think he's happy with that victory? No. He don't care about the winner's share of the purse. No. He's thinking about the Nature Boy. With some excitement in your eyes, Savage.
Yeah, he's going to get some and snap into Slim Jim back to the beach.
He snapped already. Look at his eyes.
The Macho Man Randy Savage continues his winning ways, but he's thinking of one man, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, and he'll see him a week from Sunday at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach, Brain.
Well, everybody's concentrating here. Savage is concentrating on Flair. Savage is concentrating on not pinning Flair, not making him give up, but finishing the career of Ric Flair. And speaking about finishing careers, what do you think Vader's got in mind for the Hulkster?
I think we know what he has in mind. We've seen the roadkill to him. Right now, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund, standing by with the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Woo!
Fans, you've just seen him in action. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, coming up 1 week from tomorrow night, exclusively on pay-per-view, in a lifeguard match, a takeoff in the old lumberjack match. 12 to 15 lifeguards around that ring. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, is going to be facing the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. I know what frame of mind you're in, Macho Man, and I don't know if there's anything I can possibly say to soothe you until you meet Flair.
Not a problem. I told you last time, Colonel Parker, him Bunkhouse Buck, wrong place, wrong time. Said that, didn't I? And I didn't lie. I just in the ring was nothing. I'm being nice. This is me being a nice guy. But calm before the storm. No more Mr. Nice Guy. Yeah. I'm gonna take that thing and put it in overdrive. Yeah. You understand that, Nature Boy? Yeah. You don't want to mess with what I hear for you. Yeah. Bass at the beach. Guards around the ring. Thought I set an example, but you just bring me to another boiling point, but that's okay, because it's all a test, and 1,000 years from now, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, that's the beach, brother. I am going to prove to you that you should not have messed with the Macho Man.
Or your father.
Goes without saying, Jimmy. I'll see you in Southern California, yeah, at the Bass at the Beach, because I am the Shark Attack.
The intensity certainly is there. Time could be running out for the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. 1 week from tomorrow night in Huntington, California, at the beach. It is going to be one bash you will not soon forget. From all of us here at World Championship Wrestling, it has been a great Saturday night. We'll see you next time out right here.